So we are the public health group, and I'm Milind Tambe, and I'm going to be presenting on behalf of our group. And so we have some problems that we thought are ready for immediate collaboration. And I'm going to ask my teammates to jump in if I misrepresent anything. And so immediate collaboration and then interesting long-term problems. So immediate collaboration is assignment and scheduling of health worker visits with dynamically generated data. So as I understand it, the challenge is we have health workers and they have to plan routes over, each person is assigned maybe 1,000 people, have to visit on a large geography. They have to ideally visit each and every home, but that may not work. So you may do a risk-based routing. So people who have a higher risk, you want to make sure that they do get visited. And so this problem becomes one of a traveling salesman problem, but interesting because there's some places have a higher value to be visited. And then the problem can be made more and more complicated because we may want to optimize which health worker takes on which route. The routes may not be known in advance, so there may be learning of the routes as we go on. We might want to build on existing relationships and so forth. So we created a four-part evaluation of each problem that we discussed. Social relevance, how interesting is it from an AI perspective, collaboration opportunity, and data, availability of data. And this problem seemed to score high in terms of all of these dimensions. And so this we considered as our top priority. A second problem was risk-based targeting of patients for tele-advising and monitoring. You can see that there is some overlap here in the risk-based approach. So basic idea is that this is a problem where we have to call patients. Unfortunately, if we call them, we can't, if we call all the patients all the time, it's very costly to the patients. And so can we target which patients are more risk prone, and therefore those are the ones you would target a little bit more. And so this is apparently something where the Gates Foundation has data and something where we'll be putting, we may have some contacts in order to get that data. This the first problem that I mentioned, this assignment problem, it seems like there's already years of data available. And so that's why this seemed to be the more interesting problem to focus on right away. So these two are our problems for immediate collaboration. And then longer term, possibly more challenging problems was slum health monitoring. Here we are trying to geolocate diseases within a slum, predict some areas are prone to certain diseases, and therefore recommend actions to stock medicine, awareness camps, screen for certain diseases in those areas. This is also a problem of portfolio optimization because we are trying to figure out which medicines to stock up on. The one negative here, it seems negative, or is that it seems like this problem has already received a lot of attention, and so as such, it wouldn't be up to us to. We wouldn't be necessarily the first ones to go into this. We may have to coordinate with lots of other groups, but certainly a very important problem and something that would be a longer-term interesting problem to work on. Another one is educating adolescents on sexual and reproductive health, and this is possibly a peer-based approach. So we might take an approach similar to the work we've done using social networks to educate people, but the cultural context here may be far more complex. And so it wasn't clear if from an AI perspective it would be as interesting, but certainly a very complicated problem. Decision aids for health workers based on decision trees. So we want to have these health workers ask questions to diagnose diseases. However, we can't ask lots of questions. So what's the right set of questions to ask? How to develop, so there's a PomDP style framework that could be developed to generate these questions. It seemed that this could be a problem that's really important, but maybe doesn't need a very large scale collaboration. But we are sort of keeping it in terms of a problem that will be in the future. So go on, please.
So I know that Brian Dirancy, who used to be at UW and now he's at Cape Town, he has been working on such a system for some time.
I see. Okay.
Brian Dirancy.
Okay.
For decision trees and using that to have an app that helps health workers.
Okay. Wonderful. Wonderful. Okay, so that's my presentation on behalf of the Public Health Group. Does anybody else from the group want to add any comments, anything? Okay.